Hey, brothers and sisters, this is Brother Patrick from coming to you from North Carolina at this time. I'm back at the extended stay America here. The good news is I was able to go online and find a, got some kind of an agency thing online. I was able to get it for $850 a month, and that includes you. You know, you have your utilities, internet, free internet. It's got, even has television. You know, maid service once a week, all this kind of stuff. So it's not bad. But the downside of it is, of course, it's a studio place here. It's just a one room. So I'm back to that, trying to do my prayer and stuff and make videos when my son is taking a bath. He's three now, so it's more difficult. Actually, it was easier when he was two. Now he's becoming a little bit smart on how long is he's in there and stuff like that. I was asking you to pray about that, brothers and sisters. So, you know, I'm keeping the budget as, you know, as tight as I can. Anyway, brothers and sisters, I want to do an update. You know, I mentioned about going up to the Northeast. Actually, I'll be in the Philadelphia area, which I mentioned before. This Memorial Day weekend, I'll be doing a wedding up there. After that, I'll be coming back down here. I've got it, all my stuff's been in storage for 7 years. I'm going to be fooling with all of that. And I have some elderly relatives who are sickly and whatnot. I'm going to visit all these those guys, some of them I haven't seen in 7 years. And in this area. And then in the third weekend of July, I will be in West Virginia. I forgot the name of the place right now. It's, North Central West Virginia. I'll announce it later anyway. I think that's going to be July the 19th and 20th. Sister Holly WV, a regular commenter on my videos, who also makes videos. She'll be the one who's kind of the coordinator there, the host. We're going to be meeting there at a Holiday Inn Express in the conference room, either individually or as a group, if you guys want to see me in that area. Then during the next week, it looks like I'll be in the Toledo, Ohio area. I really can't be up there the next weekend. But during the week, I have to contact the people up there, Sister Paulette, and see if they'll be able to meet me during the week. They have several people up there. If you'd like to meet me in the Toledo, Ohio area, please let me know. I mean, if enough people want to meet me, then I can stay on through the next weekend. I mean, it's just, it's open, brothers and sisters. So I'm still looking to go up into the northeastern United States there the last 2 weeks of July. And some people have contacted me and I forgot. If that was you, please contact me again, because I have forgotten and have not got it organized properly. I was going to wait till I got here. Anyway, brothers and sisters, we're all tired out and jet lagged out. We flew into, you know, it took us a day to fly, you know, from our island to Manila. And then we flew from Manila to Tokyo, Tokyo to Atlanta, which is like 13 hours, then Atlanta to Dallas. Then there's a sister who loaned me a van. That's why I went to Dallas, and then I drove up. And of course, there's lots of brothers and sisters in Dallas who I saw before. I wanted to see again, but I was only there for like 36 hours. I was only able to see one brother. And then I drove up here all the way to North Carolina. It takes like 2 days, and then now I've been here for a couple of days and going up to Philadelphia, which takes a day. Memorial Day weekend, going past Washington, D.C. I'm sure it's going to be a real fun time. Driving up there and back. Anyway, brothers and sisters, the sister that owns, who was nice enough to loan me the van that I've been using all the times that I've been coming to the States, Sister Elaine, she had bought an RV. If you remember, people who are regular viewers of my videos, you remember that I had this RV when I first, I even made a video of the storm cloud. It's like a sideways looking tornado slash looks like some kind of a beast looking, dragon looking thing in the sky. And in that video, you can see the RV. And since that time, that RV has been parked since last August, or the beginning of September, maybe, end of August, at Sister Rosemary's house, Rosemary Kelly, here in North Carolina. And I just was going to mention that. I've been praying about that since last August, that it would be sold because of some kind of a special anniversary edition. And if you look at the comments under my video, you can contact Sister Rosemary. If you're interested in an RV or know anybody that is, if not, please pray about it, that she will get that RV sold. for the highest possible price, because it's supposed to be some kind of a special edition, and she would at least get her money back, brothers and sisters. I ask you to pray about that. I ask you to pray also because, you know, she's let me borrow her van for temporary, brothers and sisters, and I'm going to be here in the States like 9 months out of the year. And it looks like by the grace of God from every January, like January, February, March, I'll be in the Philippines. And then, you know, say March 15th or so until the next January 15th. Every year I'll be in the States. And doing the tours and revivals and crusades and visiting people and giving them a word and pray for them from the Lord. Healing from the Lord, words from the Lord, whatever God would do. Revivals and all that. So I need to get a vehicle like this minivan that this sister Elaine let me borrow is a really good deal. So I ask you guys to pray about that for me also, that the right someone would either give me a car or someone else would loan me a car, or I would get a car at a real cheap price, or, you know, people would donate the money to me to buy a decent enough one to drive around. As an example, you guys who follow my videos, I think I mentioned this. You know, there's someone that wanted a couple different people said, here, you can borrow my car, but, you know, you can only drive it within this local area because it's like 15 years old and, you know, it's got bad brakes, it's got bad tires, all this kind of stuff, and, you know, you can't really take it. Well, you know, I've got a 3-year-old and my wife, and I'm driving all over the United States and even into Canada. I have lots of people up in Canada I'm going to be driving up there, Toronto area and Vancouver area. So east and west coast of Canada. And, you know, you cannot take a car that's going to be breaking down on you. The cost of getting it, you know, even though I got AAA, but the cost of, you know, getting it repaired, by the time you start, climbing around with lots of repairs, it's a huge risk, the fact that you might come out better having a better car. Because if you have a car that, say, the transmission messes up, it could be thousands of dollars, you know, and then that's probably, you know, what an old car is worth. So, you know, this, when you get an old car like that, there's nothing wrong with that for local travel. And I've, you know, done that, like in the Philippines. I had an older car, an old raggedy car that I drove around. But it's just local, you know. There's no problem with that, you know. But when you start going long distances or parts of the U.S., you're traveling, and there's areas where, you know, there's no gas station for 100 miles or whatever. You know, and especially if you've got a family, it'd be irresponsible for me to do that. So, brothers and sisters, I ask you to help me pray about that. Still, I'm not 100% sure where I'm going to be living. You know, I was just thinking about this. You know, I've been giving lots of people words, and there's new people that's messaged me for a word, and I haven't even started a new list because I've been traveling. I got to go back to the other videos and get the names and put together a list. But I'm asking you guys for a word. Those of you who can hear from the Lord, where will I live? I believe the Lord has spoken to me about where I will live, and it's not a place that I was thinking about. And I think the Lord spoke to me twice. It's one of those things where, A, because I didn't want to hear it, or B, you know, when it's like this. Those of you who can hear from the Lord, you know what I'm talking about. Sometimes the Lord speaks to you totally, clearly, loudly in your head, in your heart, and you know, hey, that's the Lord, and it's 100%. And then there's times where you think you heard from the Lord, or it could have been your own idea. It's kind of iffy. And then there's times when I said, well, that was just had to be my idea. And then it turned out that it wasn't. It was really the Lord. And there was times where I thought, well, that was the Lord, but it was really my idea. So, and it can depend on if you want to hear something or you don't. You know, your emotions, your flesh gets in the way sometimes. So this is one of those cases where it's an area I think the Lord spoke to me that I really don't want to go live there. Or I never had any idea. I never actually been to this place. I've been by the place, never stopped there. I don't know if I would like it or not. So I ask you to pray. And I would have totally dismissed it as you know, and just waited. But someone, one person, actually messaged me and said, hey, the Lord is speaking to me that you'll move to this place. And that was the place that the Lord, but he said the state. But the Lord gave me the actual city within the state. So anyway, I'm asking you, brothers and sisters, to pray for me. I pray for you. Lots of you guys are giving you words. I'm asking for a word. Because we all see in partly, we all prophesy in part, we all see through a glass darkly, as the Lord would allow us. That's what the King James uses, those words. We, you know, we can just see a little bit here, a little bit there, and the Bible says there's wisdom in a multitude of counsel. So I ask you guys to pray for me, and if you hear from the Lord where you think the Lord wants me to live, you know, to do the ministry, please let me know. And also, if you are in the any part of the United States, please private message me, or you can even comment on this video. You know, I'm going to be going to Oregon, Seattle, Vancouver, all up there in the West Coast, down to L.A., Bakersfield, over to Las Vegas. I don't know when I'm going to do that. By the grace of God, I'm going to do all that, all of this before January. I think January 15th of this coming year, I'll be going to Philippines January 15th to March 15th, because we're going to be building another orphanage, as far as I know. That's the time frame. So before that, by the grace of God, I'm going to try to go to all these places in the United States. So Northeast, July, which I made a video. If you go back and look at my videos about the tour, just anywhere in the United States, contact me and we'll try to schedule it. And I believe that I might even be going to New York City. I mentioned that in the last video. I got a word from the Lord about even going to New York City. And someone has contacted me now, and it seems like I might be in New York City. I'm waiting to hear back from them for revival preaching. So I ask you, brothers and sisters, to pray about that. That this window of opportunity for doing a revival, being part of a revival in New York City, will go through. Seems that it will be, by the grace of God, because the Lord had already spoken to me about it. So brothers and sisters, I ask you to pray about that. This is a video where I'm asking for personal prayer. The Lord has given me lots of great videos to make, and just I ask you to pray that there's a way I can have, because I've been putting my family second all the time, and I know that a lot of you guys, it's only theory for you. But some of you actually live that way. But it's not the easiest thing in the world to keep a balance in your life. But in this studio hotel room, it's very difficult, brothers and sisters. And when I first did it last year, starting last August, as they say, ignorance is bliss. But now that we've been going through it so much, it wears thin. It wears old, brothers and sisters. I ask you guys to pray, Lord, to make a way we can be in a place with like a separate one bedroom so I can go in the bedroom and pray without them having to take a bath, or me to go in the bathroom and try to pray. I usually play worship music while I'm trying to pray, and then it's nice if you have a little bit of privacy, and I can be much more effective for the Lord. The anointing, getting words from the Lord, praying, getting effective prayer and all that is a priceless thing. You have to have space sometimes to do that. So here, brothers and sisters, this is a video of me asking for your help and all those things about the RV for Sister Elaine, to get it sold as soon as possible at a fair, the right price of at least what she paid for it, that she won't lose any money on it, and it go above that, exceed, and actually be blessed for trying to help me do God's work, that she will actually be able to sell it for more than she paid for it and actually come out ahead, because she'd have her expenses of the taxes and the registration and all that above the price anyway she paid. And then for the a vehicle, brothers and sisters, I need to get a vehicle and give Sister Elaine back her van, sometime this summer, because she loaned it to me temporarily. And, of course, that was so nice of her. She didn't have to do that. And I want to say this to all those you guys who have donated to Joshua's Ministry in the Philippines. Some of you donated to me here, on the joshuasministry.com, that the link. It's McCourt. McCorland, I don't have it memorized. Brother Martin McCorland there in Australia, he handles all the donations that we bundle together through PayPal and then transfer down to the Philippines. Reduces the cost greatly instead of Western Union and stuff like that. And then those who have helped me do the ministry here, the revival tours and praying for people and all this stuff and the words for people, ministering to people here in the United States or wherever the Lord would send me, Canada, Europe, by the grace of God, we plan to go to Europe. Plan on taking a tour group to Israel. By the grace of God, it's in my spirit to do it September 2015. I'm waiting on a final confirmation from that. There's a brother Bruce in Baton Rouge who will help me to schedule that and coordinate that. And I'm going to get together with Brother Bruce when I get down to Louisiana to Baton Rouge, like in August or September, and we'll have it lined up and announce it. By the grace of God, so I'm just tentatively planning that we'll take a tour group. If you want to go, come on, let's go. We'll be there for the Feast of Trumpets, the last blood moon, September 2015, and that's in my spirit from the Lord. May we be raptured from Israel. Now, wouldn't that be cool? Because, I'm looking for the rapture every day, but I'm doing the work of the Lord. Lots of you guys are all balanced, and you just keep looking for the rapture without do anything for the Lord. Some people are busy doing stuff for the Lord and not looking for the Lord. And the Lord said there's a crown. The Bible says there's a crown of righteousness for those who love his appearing. The Apostle Paul said, So we should love his appearing, but yet we should make hay while the sun is shining. We should labor while it's called today, you know, because night is coming when no man can work. Jesus said, so is daylight, we must work, brothers and sisters. So, you know, even though I'm jet lagged, I'm tired, you know, it's been a week now, or more than a week since we started traveling, like last Wednesday, and I bet I haven't had 6 hours of sleep a day. But by the grace of God, you know, what keeps me going, even though it, in my flesh, it's about as much fun as probably, you know, fingernails on a chalkboard. But I know that I'm, you know, trying to move in God's will and do his will in my life and go forward with all the things he would have me do. And that's what sustains me, knowing that I'm doing things what God wants me to do. You know, in all the bad times and all the foolishness and all the, you know, the necessities of life that are a hindrance to our, you know, walking in the spirit, just a natural everyday life in our flesh, you know, is but a, you know, it's but a moment in the eternity with Christ. Brothers and sisters, I have so many great videos to make that the Lord's been speaking to me about. And I know the real revival, you know, the video I made the other day was pretty good, but the Lord's really been speaking to me and giving me three great messages today, this afternoon. Just boom, he just dropped them on me. Three great messages of revival, brothers and sisters. And I'm going to make videos about them. By the grace of God, I'll be preaching them in churches, I believe. And I spoke by the Spirit of God this January, like January the 1st or December 31st. I made a video January 1st or 2nd. Where Lord had spoke to me that he was going to, you know, this time when I come to the States, he's going to open up the churches. And I believe that's true. The Lord will really open up the churches for me to bring the revival message. You read in Revelation chapter 2 and 3, Jesus spoke to the churches. And he called for revival. He called for repentance. That's just one of the messages that the Lord gave me. Revival is a fruit of repentance. If my people who are called by my name will humble themselves and pray and seek my face and turn from their wicked ways. You know, those old denominational churches, they love to keep talking about, yeah, those people out there need to repent. I'm glad I repented 20 years ago. I'm glad I got saved 20 years ago. No. Solomon was speaking by the Spirit of God at the dedication of the temple, 2 Chronicles 7:14. He said, if my people, God's people, who are called by my name, would humble themselves, they're already part of God's people, humble themselves and pray and seek my face and turn from their wicked ways, I will heal from heaven. I will forgive their sins and I will heal their land. That's God speaking to his people. That's the revival verse. So that's why when Jesus is talking to the churches, he says, he tells the good stuff they're doing and the bad stuff they're doing, and then he says, therefore repent. Repent. Turn from what you're doing your way, your will, and do my will. Not my will be done, but thy will be done. That's just a quick overview of one of the messages that the Lord gave me. I got two more awesome ones. I just want to give you a little brief because I'm excited about these messages. It says, you know, when talking about baptism in 1 Corinthians, I believe it's about chapter 2 or 3, maybe even chapter 1, Paul says that, I'm talking about people being, were you baptized in my name? Were you baptized in the name of Apollos? And there was a preacher named Apollos there, and from the book of Acts, who Priscilla and Aquila taught a better way about baptism of the Holy Spirit and all that stuff. Anyway, so Paul said, you know, Apollos, you know, one sows and another one waters, but God gives the increase. So the second message that the Lord gave me for revival is just the emphasis on that sentence. God gives the increase. You know, you can preach all day long. You can evangelize all day. You can testify. You can, witness to people all day long. And then someone can water. You can pray for people. The Spirit of God can, you know, and all this. You know, by watering, you know, repeating and reaffirming the Word of God. But God gives the increase. So the message is that for revival, revival is God giving the increase. The move of the Spirit of God. That's what I'm talking about. And I, you know, go on into that. So anyway, brothers and sisters, and there's a third one, and I'll save that one for next time just to mention. I'll make a full video on each one of these and really preach it. And that's when the Spirit moves. When it's preached, you can teach. And that's great. I mean, you lay the foundation. And, you know, I've done lots of teaching. And there's lots of people tell me, oh, you know, I like it when you're talking nicely. They want me to teach. But teaching and preaching is two different things. Preaching is when God moves. The power of the Spirit moves on the foundations you receive from teaching when there's preaching. It motivates you to be open to the Spirit of God to work on you. Open your heart through the sword of the Spirit. That sword of the Spirit circumcises your heart. The word of God circumcises your heart. That's why the Bible says, "I wish God says He wishes you would circumcise your heart, not your flesh." Brothers and sisters, rend your heart, tear your heart, and not your garments. You know, in the Old Testament, when they would fast and pray, or they would be in mourning and all this, they'd rip their clothes, throw dust on their head. You know, and God says, "I wish you would rend your heart, tear your heart, and not your garments." You know, stop doing this outward appearance stuff. Oh, don't let me get started on religion. That's a whole nother revival sermon right there. Stop doing all that outward appearance. That's what religion is. Outward ceremony is. You know, I do that. Oh, I do my little dominus, obinus, stupidus, retardedus moves, and all this kind of, you know, some kind of ceremonial stuff. When in reality, we need to rend our heart, not our garments. Brothers and sisters, I have, like I said, I'm way behind on my sleep, way jet lagged. I had lots of funny one-liners to give you guys too, but I can't think of them right now. That's been in my mind because I haven't made any videos, and all these things have been coming into my mind. But brothers and sisters, I appreciate all of you guys. And like I said, as I started, you know, I got off topic, believe it or not, when I was talking about Brother Martin and then those who have donated through to my email address for helping me do the ministry work in the States. I just want to tell you, I thank all you guys who's helped me, you know, and of course I got a long way to go to do the work of God. I know God will provide, and God will use His people to provide. I want to thank you for all who've helped, and for those who are helping in the future. Thank you for helping us. We're going to, by the grace of God, I already did a video of those who are the husband and wife, Pastor Raul and his wife, Sister Daisy, who've been in the ministry for about 20 years. I've been working with them since 2005. They've been doing lots of the feedings, over half of the feedings we do. I think we're doing like 8 feedings, and I guess they do about 4 of them. So half of the feedings they do. And I've been working with them, like I said, since 2005, just like the first house mom. You know, I've been working with her since the same time. They're from the same group. Faith Family Church it's called. But anyway, brothers and sisters, they're, by the grace of God, they will be our third house mom and dad. They have grown children who are all so in the ministry, who also work with for some other work they do for the Lord. So by the grace of God, those guys will also be house moms and dads in the future, you know, because they're a servant family. Like my wife's family, most of them serve the Lord too. Anyway, brothers and sisters, God bless. I better go and get some sleep. I got to get up and drive to Philadelphia early tomorrow morning and ask you to pray for us. Safe travels and return. If anybody wants to see me in Philadelphia, you better let me know, because if not, I'm coming back here to North Carolina Sunday. But if there's people that want to see me Sunday afternoon, I'll stay another night in Philadelphia. I need to know. God bless you guys. Love you. Thank you. Thank you for everything, all the help. Just keep praying for me, because, you know, it's the Bible says, "Except the Lord build the house, those that labor in vain." Psalm 127. You know, and so, and Psalm 133, they go together. "How beautiful and pleasant it is when brethren dwell together in unity. It's like the oil that ran down Aaron's beard, even down his garment, to the hem of his garment." Psalm 133. It goes with 127, which I'm saying here. That's a whole other, that's the other message. I already touched on it. You know, you have to be in unity, in the bond of peace. Spirit of unity and the bond of peace is Christians. Not compromising the gospel and just let's be union, you know, and have unity with Mormons and Jehovah's Witnesses and all that. But unity amongst us born-again Christians. And then when we dwell together in unity, brothers and sisters, as the Lord is the one building the house, Jesus is our high priest. Aaron is a type, you know, is the high priest in the Old Testament, type of Christ. And that oil, the anointing, the Holy Spirit is running down from the head down to the body. So if we want revival to move, we have to dwell together in unity. How beautiful and pleasant it is when brethren dwell together in unity. That's when the anointing comes. That's when revival comes. When all those people on YouTube are not even pastors, they're a bunch of foolishness. They don't even know what they're talking about. On there making videos, calling everybody false prophets because you don't agree with their belief about the rapture. You don't agree with what they believe. They have some personal, you know, there's people who've had this personal revelation and stigmatas and visions from the Lord. And then when they get on there and make a video and they don't quote the Word of God, they say this special revelation they had. Brothers and sisters, there's a big difference. I'm not the only one, but I use myself as an example. When I come on here and say I had a dream from the Lord and start telling what the Lord showed me, I also have Bible verses. Jesus said, and the Old Testament tells us in the law, Jesus repeated, "Let everything be established by two or more witnesses," two or three witnesses. So you had to have at least two or three Bible verses to back up what you're talking about. Not, brother so-and-so, this guy says this, but he's a false prophet because I had a special revelation that says baptism of the Holy Spirit is when you get a stigmata or, you know, some kind of a, you know, without no quote from the Bible, just your own opinion, your own ideas, your own vain imaginations. There's lots of stuff on YouTube, and that's where all the people getting into trouble asking me questions when they're listening to people talk. Number one, you need to read your Bible, particularly the New Testament. Get in the New Testament. It's pretty cut and dry as far as, you know, when you start reading the law, it's like, and the prophets in the Old Testament, it's like, some of that stuff's already been, most of it's already been fulfilled. You've got to be, have a PhD of ancient Middle Eastern history, you know, to even know what they're talking about. All the names of those countries have changed and following the whole thing, if it's been fulfilled or not, and all this stuff. You know, that's what theologians are for. Now, as far as reading it to get something out of it for personal understanding and gain, that's a whole other thing. But trying to translate, interpret it, and apply prophecies from the Old Testament to this and that and the other. The New Testament, all things are fulfilled in Christ. That's what the Bible tells us. You stick with all things fulfilled in Christ, you're doing good. And nobody's private interpretation and private foolishness off YouTube. Like I said, even when I tell you, oh, I had a dream or a vision, it's still taken with a grain of salt. The Word of God still is our standard. It's still the triumph. You don't say, oh, Brother Patrick said so-and-so, so this is it. No, the Word of God is it. And I take what someone says in consideration and judgment and compared to the Word of God as a secondary thing, not equal to the Word of God, brothers and sisters. Anyway, brothers and sisters, I've done enough talking, rambling, preaching, going all around. God bless you guys. I'll let you go. They've been in the bath for a while because I prayed also. So I asked you to pray for my wife. She's been doing pretty good about that. And for my son, Matthew, you know, because they've given up a lot for the Lord. And, you know, I'm the one that's called to serve the Lord. And, you know, so I want to be fair to them, you know. And in the past, I would say I wasn't as considerate about that. But sometimes it's in my heart to be considerate, you know, as I should be for my family. And lots of people don't care. And some of you guys do. And I appreciate that. And I'm just asking you to pray. God to make a way that we can have a one-bedroom place where I can close the door or whatever without them having to take a bath. God bless you guys. Love you guys. And the Lord has got me still traveling. But I'm praying that I will have a home base, like a house we can live in, rent, or even whatever. Or someone have a house we can use or whatnot. Or we'll rent a house, whatever. Or an apartment. And then I can go out instead of, and sometimes they can stay there, you know, without having to go with me everywhere and stay in hotels and stuff like that. And God will make a little bit better way that's easier for them to endure. Because, everybody has a breaking point. And, you know, by the grace of God, God will give us the grace for another day. But, you got to do the best you can also to be able to endure and pace yourself. God bless you guys.